Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we'll be working on typography and text effect. Firstly, we'll trace out the text from the sketch using the pen tool, then create a pattern brush to apply to the stroke. Further, we'll add shadows and highlights in Photoshop. So let's begin the tutorial. For this design, I have drawn out some hand-drawn sketches to create a nice typography. I have chosen this sketch to continue with the designing process. So open a new Illustrator document, drag and drop the sketch from the folder, scale down the size and start tracing the text using a pen tool. Draw each alphabet separately. To break the endpoints, click on the point where they all pressed. Follow the curves as per the sketch. Adjust the vertices to get the perfect shape. Once the tracing is complete, increase the stroke thickness to 4 points and start refining the vertices using the handles. Make sure the endpoints are perfectly aligned with the strokes. Now, draw a rectangle using the rectangle tool, apply fill color, double click on the fill color to open the color picker panel. Choose light brown color and click OK. Reduce the thickness and create two duplicates using the shortcut Command or Control C to copy and Command or Control F to paste in front. Then rotate the top rectangle to 45 degree angle. Now select the top and the second rectangle and apply intersect option under Pathfinder. This will leave only the intersect shape. Select the shape and apply fill color. Put the values and click OK. We got a nice orange color. Next, duplicate the shape once using the same shortcut. Scale up the size and apply stroke color. Set the stroke thickness to 1 point and go to Object Path Outline Stroke. This will convert the stroke to fill color. Now, create a duplicate of the base rectangle. Select the shape and rectangle and again apply intersect option. Then under color picker panel, change the values to apply dark brown color. Reduce the shape of the rectangle from both sides. Next, duplicate the rectangle and arrange it to front. Scale down the size and apply black color. Under transparency, change the mode to multiply and opacity to around 21%. Then with the alt pressed, create a duplicate of the shape. Change the object mode to overlay, then change the color to white and set the opacity to 65%. Duplicate one more shape and reduce the thickness. Set the opacity to 32%. Duplicate two more shapes. Set the opacity to 21% and 37%. Let's increase the opacity of big shape to 100%. Second one, 66%, third to 61% and the last one to 30%. We got a depth due to shades and highlights. Next, create a circle same size of the rectangle and fill it up with the same color. Draw out a rectangle covering the half portion of the circle. Then, selecting both the shapes, apply intersect on the Pathfinder. We are left with only half of the circle. Now, select all the highlight shapes and create a duplicate. Place it over the half circle, arrange it to front, align one of the sides according to the semicircle. Then, using the Shape Builder tool, separate out the remaining shapes, then select and delete it out. We'll use this semicircular design to create the start and end tabs for the pattern. So firstly, open the swatch panel. Now select the design and drag and drop it to swatches. It will create a new color swatches on the panel. Next, open the reflect panel and reflect the design vertically. Now again, drag and drop it to swatch to create one more color swatch. Next, open brush panel, select our rectangular design and drag and drop it to panel. This will open a brush panel. Here, choose pattern brush and click OK. Now, under pattern brush option, open and dial and choose the first design we have created. Then for the start tile, choose the second design. Lastly, for the inner corner tile, we'll choose auto sliced option and click OK. Now select the focus typography stroke and apply a pattern brush. Immediately, a new pattern brush will be applied to the stroke. You can reduce the stroke thickness to around 0.5 points. Now add a background using the rectangle tool and lock it using the shortcut Command or Control tool. Select the typography and set the stroke thickness to 0.7 points. Let's do some arrangement. Select the stroke and arrange it to front, C to front and U on the top. Adjust the vertices using the direct selection tool. Use handle tools to refine the curves. Do this for all the other alphabets. In the next part, we'll import this candy pattern typography to Photoshop, where we'll add text effect, shadows, reflection, glossiness, and finally adjust the color tone. In this episode, we have created typography from sketch. We have also understood how to create pattern brush, which can be applied to any stroke. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you are more business designing, like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.